Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So students, since we know thoroughly that what is rate law and the experimental components that are involved in the rate law, that is X and Y. So related to this thing, the order of reaction is also a very important thing that we should know. And what is the order of reaction? Let us see. So let us see what is the order of reaction. So the order of a chemical reaction with respect to each reactant is defined as the exponent to which the concentration term of the reactant in the rate law is raised. Let me give you a brief idea that suppose I have earlier explained that A raised to X and B raised to Y. So in this case, the order of reaction for the component A, or I could say that the order of reaction for the reactant A is now X, and for the reactant B will be Y. So based on that, we'll study that what is order of reaction. So according to rate law, the rate is equals to K A raised to X and B raised to Y. So the order of the concentration of A is X and the order of concentration of B is Y. So the overall order of reaction will be what? So the overall order of reaction will be the sum of the exponents, that is experimental exponents, to which the concentration terms are raised. In this case, A raised to X, B raised to Y. So therefore, this experimental exponents are raised to the reactants. And what we have to do? We have to make it a sum of it, that is X plus Y. So in this case, the X plus Y will be the overall order of reaction. It's very much simple. So let us see an example so that we could describe what is actually the order of reaction. I have mentioned an example like H2 plus I2 will give you 2 times HI. So the rate law that has been mentioned for this equation was found to be rate is equals to K H2 into I2. In this case, as you can see, there should have been a presence of H2 raised to X, which is already there. But in this case, this X is 1, which means the concentration of H2 is first order. While that of the I2, there should have been a presence of Y. But in this case, the Y is equals to 1. So therefore, Y which is equals to 1, which means the concentration of I2 is also first order. So for each reactant, the order can be different or will be the same. So our main concern is what would be the overall order of reaction. So for that instance, suppose if I would say the overall order of reaction will be X plus Y. So in this case, 1 plus 1, which means 2. So basically this whole reaction is a second order reaction, means this reaction will depend on the two reactants. That is for H2 also and for I2 also. Suppose if this reaction would have been a first order reaction, then the whole reaction would have been dependent on only on one reactant and not on the other. So therefore the order of reaction can be 1, can be 2, 3 or can be 0 also. Means the reaction would not depend on the reactant, it will go on simultaneously, it will go in a very spontaneous process. So this was the order of reaction, and we could determine the order of reaction also. So for now, the order of reaction is, it is the experimental components, it is the sum of the experimental components of the reactants raised based on the rate law. So I hope you have got to know what is order of reaction. and we'll do the further things also in the next lecture. So thank you friends for watching this video, and I hope you have liked this video, and please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.